Now students will move on to question number 3 of exercise 4.2. Yesterday we completed 4.1 ka question number 1. Question number 1 and 2 are similar, so I have done one question. Now we'll go for question number 3. Draw a circle of radius 3.6 cm. You have to take a radius of 3.6 cm and draw a circle. Draw a tangent to the circle at any point on it without using the center. Now yes, it is specified that you should not use the center of the circle. So according to given information, we'll draw one rough figure. You can see a circle, and then without using the center, a tangent is drawn. L is tangent to the circle at point C. So we'll start with the fair construction. Now student, first we will draw a circle with radius 3.6 cm. See, I am not using the pencil because it will not be clearly visible. I am using the pen, but students, strictly for construction, you have to use pencil. Construction should be done only with pencil. So 3.6, I will take a radius. This is 3.6. And then first I will take a center. Center O. And then I will draw a circle. This is my circle. Now, without using the center, so what I will do? I will take three vertex or three points here, and I will name it A, B, and C, and then I will join this. You can see a triangle is formed here. Now I will draw a tangent. You can draw a tangent passing through any points A or B. I will draw it through C. So see what the step is. I will take a convenient span at A, and I will draw an arc with same span. We should not move the span. With same span, I will keep it at C and cut an arc. I am drawing the congruent angle actually, see. So now what I will do, I will keep it here, and then I will draw congruent angle. You can see here exactly the same span. You can see tip of the compass over here and pencil over here, same span. I will keep it here on this baseline, and then I will intersect this arc. And now what I will do, I will draw a straight line passing from point C also and from the center of the arc. So this is my required tangent to the circle. This is the center of the arc and L. Final statement C, line L is the required tangent to the circle at point C. And then see, I will join the radius from O center to B. This is my radius. Now I will take question number 4. Draw a circle of radius 3.3 cm. You have to take radius 3.3 cm and draw a circle. Now see, next, draw a chord PQ of length 6.6 cm. Now you can see radius is 3.3 and the chord is 6.6, means it is diameter, because diameter is exactly double the radius. Draw tangents to the circle at point P and Q and write observation about the tangents. Now see, I have drawn a rough diagram. You can see here, circle with center O. This is the radius and PQ is the diameter, which is exactly 6.6, and these are the required tangents. This is the rough diagram. So now we'll start with the fair construction. As the radius is 3.3, so first I will take a span of 3.3 compass, see. So I will take a center O, and then I will draw a circle with radius 3.3 cm, and it is given that chord, we have to draw chord PQ which is of length 6.6, exactly it is a diameter. So what I will do now, see, I have to, this is my PQ, the chord is PQ. So I will extend the line. First I will draw and show you.
radius was 3.3. So 6.6, see, this is the exact 6.6, which is the diameter. So this is P and this is Q. As I have to draw the tangents from point P and Q, I have to extend this line. So from both the ends, I will extend it. Now see what I will do. I will keep it here at P, and I will take a convenient span, whichever is convenient. P, same span I will keep it at Q. And draw two arc. Now I will bisect this both arc. Suppose if I name this as A, B, and these two arc as CD, so I will bisect this both arc. See, you can see here, I will take more than half of these, and I will take more than half of this, and then draw two arc same here. See, this is more than half, one above the circle and one below the circle. Again, see here, I will keep it at C, and I will intersect this. So now see, I will draw tangents which will exactly pass from the center and also touch the circle C. And here see, so this is line L. And this is line M. Line L and line M are the required tangents to the circle at point P and Q. You see the final statement, line L and line M are the required tangents to the circle at point P and Q. And also we write the observation. You can see that both the tangents are parallel to each other. You can see the tangents are parallel to each other. Student, this is the sixth sum. Draw a circle with center P. See, I have drawn a rough diagram. A circle with center P. Radius is 3.4 cm. You can see radius is 3.4. This is radius, which is 3.4. Take a point Q. See, I have taken a point Q at a distance of 5.5. From center P, you have to take a distance of 5.5 and construct a tangent to the circle from point P. See, from B, I have constructed a tangent from the exterior point. So, this is a rough diagram, we will go for the fair construction. So now, see, I am taking a radius which is of 3.4 cm. And then the center is P. I will draw a circle. So I will show this. This is the radius, which is 3.4 centimeter. Now I have to take a point Q, which is in the exterior, and the distance is given 5.5. So do not draw it with scale, use the compass. So I will take a span of 5.5. This is 5.5. I will first draw a big line. This is my big line, and then what I will do, I will take a span here of 5.5. See, this is Q and this distance is 5.5 cm. Now I have to construct a tangent from exterior point Q. So what I will do, I will keep it here. And I will take two arcs. I will cut two arcs. One is here, the second one is here, and then I will bisect this. I will take more than half, one above the circle, and one here. Second, I will keep it here, and then
I will bisect it. See students, now question number 6 is, draw a circle with center P and radius 3.4 cm. So see, this is center P, rough diagram see, and the radius is 3.4 cm. Take a point Q at a distance of 5.5 cm from the center. So from P, from the center, you have to take a distance, and you have to take a point Q which is exterior of the circle and which is 5.5 cm, and draw tangents from exterior point. So see what we'll do. See, the circle is ready. I have drawn a circle with radius 3.4 cm. Now from point P, I have to take a point Q which is at a distance of 5.5. So see what I will do. We have to not draw with scalar, we have to use compass for this. See, this is 5.5 cm. So I will keep it here and cut an arc. This is Q which is at a distance of 5.5 cm. So I will draw like this. Now what I will do, I will bisect this PQ. Bisecting means taking more than half. I will take more than half. This is more than half. We'll draw two arc, one above the circle and one below the circle, and I will keep it at point P and intersect this. And then what I will do, see, I will draw a straight line passing from center of both the arcs. And here I will give the symbol of 90 degree. Now see how to draw the tangent from exterior point. I'll tell you. Name this point as M. This is M. So I will keep my compass at M and keep it at center. And then I will draw a semicircle. You can see I'm drawing a semicircle. Not full circle, semicircle. And then see what I will do now. From Q and this point, this is A and this is B. From exterior point Q, this is QA, one tangent, and this is QB, the second tangent. So QA and QB are the required tangents to the circle from the exterior point. Thank you.